أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يقول الله تعالى في القرآن العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وعبد الله ولا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا صدق الله العظيم All praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala We glorify Him and we give thanks unto Him I testify that there is none to be worshipped but Allah He is alone and he has no partner. And I testify that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and final messenger. Ibadallah, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Al-Quran, وَعَبُدُ اللَّهِ and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been created for this purpose. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ And I have only created jinn and men so that they may worship me, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ And do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are those who directly associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there are those who in an indirect way, they also associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are people who give preference to people and to things, resources, above Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not only remind us about worshiping Him alone, but He also reminds us that we should not associate partners with Him. It is a grievous sin indeed to associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا And be kind, show kindness to your parents. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, we often hear about our responsibilities, about our duties towards the ones who gave us birth, the ones who are the reason other than Allah that we are here. And we often see how much in the world that we live in today that people are very unkind and disrespectful to their parents. They do not treat them the way Allah has ordered us to do, or what was told and taught to us by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's never a matter of redundancy that you hear this often. because we need to be reminded about it. And sometimes the way things are being done in our homes with regards to the treatment of one another and how we interact with one another, it is reflected in our actions in the communities and in other places or with other people whom we interact with. And so today, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, I want to remind you and remind myself about some of the injunctions of the Quran and the traditions of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to these important people in our lives. There are a lot of times when we get close to Ramadan, there's a lot of preparation that is being made. Preparation in the house of Allah. Preparation in terms of, I want to pray more salah. I want to fast in the month of Sha'ban. I want to do this. And sometimes it's very personal. And people sometimes do not make preparation with regards to their families and with regards to their connections, with regards to making things right. There's so often that people go into Ramadan and there is total disunity in the family. Quite often we stand up and we talk about disunity in our communities and we talk about disunity among Muslims. And then we tend to forget that there is disunity among families and that we need to bring families together. That children and parents, they need to have a very close relationship. If it starts there where there is unity in the family, then it will eventually be unity in our communities and it will extend. But if we were being brought up in such a way that we are fighting and we have hatred and enmity for one another in our immediate families, then we do not expect better when it comes to the community. And so as we prepare for Ramadan, don't only think about the salah that you want to offer more in Ramadan, or all the other good actions, I want to feed people, and I want to read Quran, want to make dhikr. But think about the family. Think about bringing this family close together. Think about your relationship with your mothers and fathers and your sons and daughters. Let's think about the kindness and compassion and love that needs to be demonstrated. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us several places in the Quran about what He has enjoined with regards to parents. Allah says in the Quran, وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا, and we have enjoined upon man kind treatment towards parents. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا. الله Qawlan Kareema, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, and your Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him. immediately when he addresses his creation, he says, and your Lord has decreed that you be kind to your parents. If one or both of them attain old age during your lifetime, say not to them a word of contempt. Don't drive them away. Keep them close to you. And always lower the wings of humility towards them. Say kind words to them. Make them feel important. Make them feel wanted. And as they get older, sometimes people think that as people get older, they don't have values. And quite often, our young do that to the old. We think that they have served and they don't have any value anymore. They do have values, my dear brothers and my sisters. They do have importance to the community. They can make a difference. So make them feel happy. Make them feel that they are important, that they're required in our community. And sometimes that's the issue that we have between the young and the old. That we make people feel that you have done what you were supposed to do. We don't need you anymore. And that is why sometimes we find in our organizations and we find in our masajid that some people, they tend to hold on to power because they're afraid that whatever they have done their whole life, it would not be recognized by anybody. And people will just scorn them and just drive them away or keep them on the sideline. It is not the right thing for you to maintain or to keep that power all the time. There must be a process of transition. But at the same time, those who are being transitioned into those positions, they need to know that these people have value. And had it not been for them, you would not have had what you are having right now. And so we look back at Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, and all those great ones. And we always remember them and we give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their initiatives. For them being pioneers, for had it not been for them, we would not have been enjoying Islam today. Isn't that what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the Battle of Badr, just before that battle began? He said, "Oh Allah, if this band of Muslims are being defeated today, that there will be none left on earth who will worship you." And so we give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them. And so that's a continuation. We do the same thing for our folks who have done tremendous work for our communities, for our families. We pay tribute to our parents for their kindness and their affection and their love. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a beautiful hadith, "Raghima anf, thumma raghima anf, thumma raghima anf, man adraka abawayhi indal kibar ahaduhima aw kilahima falam yadkhul al janna." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "May his nose be rubbed in dust." And he said it three times, meaning may that person be humiliated, the one who was fortunate to find one or both of his parents alive in old age. He's young and they're old. And he hasn't entered paradise. He wasn't able to enter paradise, meaning that he didn't show that love and affection and that kindness to his parents. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, sometimes in this world, we think about things that are best for us. Everyone has things that he or she loves. This is what I love more than anything else. We need to look at what Allah loves more than anything else. And we need to put that into our lives. Ibn Mas'ud, he said, I asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أي العمل أحب إلى الله تعالى. This was the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They always asked about things that could please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which deed is most loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, As-salatu ala waqtiha, salah, prayers, at its prescribed time. And then he asked, what next? And he was told, birrul walidain, that you be kind and affectionate to your parents, that you show love to them. And then thirdly, he asks, and what next? And he was told, al-jihadu fi sabilillah, to struggle, to strive in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he reminded this companion that among the things that are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you be kind and compassionate and loving to your parents. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said with regards to showing their value, how important they are. He said, لا يجزي ولد والدا إلا إن يجده مملوكا فيشتريه. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one can repay a father or his father for his love and affection unless he finds him a slave. He purchases him and then he frees him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that fathers and mothers, they have great significance and value to us. And in essence, he's saying you can't repay them for their affection and for their love. No matter what you do, sometimes we give them a little here and there, and we think that we have done enough. And sometimes if it doesn't come from the children, it comes from the in-laws.
The son may say, I need to do this and this for my mother and my father. And the daughter-in-law might say, you have done enough, and vice versa. We have this so prevalent in communities today, and it's not only in non-Muslim communities, it's happening in our Muslim communities also, where so often we talk about maintaining that relationship and giving them what is due to them. And we find parents, they come crying and they talk about the ill treatment and how they have to look for things on their own even though they have reached old age. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, it is reported that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said to him, man ahaqqu an-nas bi husni suhabati. The man came and he said, ya Rasulullah, he asked, who is most deserving of my kind treatment and my companionship? And that man was told, ummuk, your mother. And then he asked again, thumma man, and he was told, ummuk, your mother. Then he asked a third time, thumma man, and he was told, ummuk, your mother. Then he asked a fourth time, and he was told, your father. This is the type of relationship that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that we should have with our parents. Sometimes we think about other people as our companions. Sometimes we want to be with other people more than our own parents. And so Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is saying that your mother is most deserving of your companionship. And also your father is deserving of your companionship. Spend time with them. Spend quality time with them. Make sure that they feel that they're important, that they have value. Always express that love and affection to them. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said when he was telling his companions about major sins, he reminded them that from among the major sins is the one who is disobedient to his parents, or to disobey your parents, it's one of the major sins. There are times in our lives when we tend to think of people just because they don't share the same faith like us, that they don't have any value, and we need to sever all type of relationship with them. Children are told not to sever relationship with their parents, even though they may not share the same faith. So your mother, your father may be a non-Muslim, you have accepted Islam, you have reverted, you have come back to Islam. They haven't been given that opportunity, as yet that guidance to come back. Don't sever relationship with them. Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with her and be pleased with her father. She said, during the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, her mother, who was a pagan, not a Muslim, came to visit her, to see her. And so she did not know what to do. She asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what should I do? Should I see her? Should I have any relationship with her? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to her, be good and kind to your mother. Maintain that relationship. Maintain that family ties. He didn't tell her to ill-treat her or to reprimand her because she is not a Muslim. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said to her, be kind and be good to your mother. Accept her, invite her, see her. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, quite often when parents leave this world, we also think that their values and their importance have been lost. No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it is said that once he was sitting with his companions, and a person came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, do parents have rights over us after they have died? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, yes, they do have rights. What is it that you should do for them? Pray to Allah to bless them with forgiveness and with His rahmah, with His mercy. Pray to Allah to always have them being forgiven, Allah, that Allah forgives them and Allah be merciful unto them. Never cease that relationship with them. Maintain relationship with your parents even after they have departed from this world. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, secondly, fulfill promises that they have made to anyone. How would we know that if we weren't close to them? How would we know that if we didn't have a relationship with them when they were alive? And so they need to be our companions. We need to be close to them so that we know what they were thinking and what they wanted to do. Maybe your parents, they made promises that if everything goes with them, they would like to make Hajj. And so at the time when they die, you look at their wealth and see if they have the means, or they had the means, and so you perform Hajj on their behalf. They made promises to Allah and promises to others. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, thirdly, he said, respect their relations and their friends. Their relations. Sometimes when parents die, people think that they need to cut off relationship. That the one who was helping us, or because of this individual, we maintain relationship. So now they are dead, they are gone, we don't have to maintain relationship with our brothers and our sisters and our uncles and our aunts, whether paternal or maternal. We don't have to, because parents are not here anymore. They may have had good friends during their lifetime. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, maintain relationship with those friends. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, As you think about Ramadan, again, I emphasize that just don't only think about your personal ibadah, about your salah and your zakah and your sawm, and about elevating or doing more. Think about if those things would be accepted, if you have enmity and hatred in your hearts for your brothers and sisters and your family members, if you don't have a relationship with your mothers and fathers, or if you don't have a relationship with your sons and daughters, then Ramadan is just becomes a regular thing. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة أن يدع طعامه ولا شرابه. He who does not give up evil speech and evil actions, Allah has no need for him to give up his food and drink. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, as we prepare for Ramadan, let us strengthen our relationship. Let us make sure that there is love and compassion and kindness for one another, especially our immediate families. Sometimes we express it so much in our communities, the love and compassion for others, and we lose it when it comes to our own. Let us strive, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, for unity within our families. Inshallah, we pray that this unity within our families will help us to unify our communities, to unify this ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. May He give us good in this life and good in the life hereafter. And may He save us from the torment of hellfire. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنات من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رضوان الله عليهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He says in the Quran, ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه حملته أمه وهنا على وهن وفصاله في عامين أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, and we have enjoined upon man to be kind to his parents, his mother beareth him in weakness upon weakness, and his weaning is in 2 years. Imagine the difficulty, the challenges that a mother goes through to bring a child into this world. Think about the pains, the sleepless nights, when the child comes into this world. I want to end with this, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. We see so many husbands, they treat their wives as if they're just an item. They do not show them any type of respect. The mothers of their children, they treat them in such a horrible manner that sometimes we see that being demonstrated by the sons, that they don't show any respect to females. And it happens in many communities where there are these type of customs and practices where women are seen as very insignificant. And so it rubs off on the children that they treat other women as being insignificant. There are boys today in school, they treat female teachers as if they don't matter. That they don't have any significance, and that comes from the home because they see how their fathers are treating their mothers. And so we need to be very careful, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Otherwise, we will bring up a community, a people that will not have any love and any compassion and any kindness. We will bring up a community of people who are disrespectful and disobedient and don't care about the other person because they think they have everything in life. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves us from that. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He guides us so that we be good parents, and that we be good sons and daughters, and that we strive every moment of our lives to maintain those family relationships. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps us to understand that everyone is valuable and everyone is important, and we must give them their due rights. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to give us good in this life and good in the life hereafter and to save us from the torment of hellfire. لَقَدْ أَمَرَنَا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ حَيْثُ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وارضى الله من خلفائه الأربعة ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الستة الباقين المبشرين بالجنة وعن سائر الصحابة وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان الى يوم الدين اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الايمان وثبت قلوبنا على دين الاسلام ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين امنوا ربنا انك رؤوف رحيم اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا حاجه من حوائج الدنيا والاخره الا قضيتها ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا ميتا الا رحمته اللهم تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا انك انت التواب الرحيم عباد الله ان الله يأمر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي اذكركم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله على نعمه واشكروه على آلائه ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون قم السلام
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر